Hello everybody and welcome to video 11 with Step-by-Step Painter 2023. Okay, so in the previous videos we've been arranging Painter, making a layout, making a workspace, and just taking you through what I generally do to set up the new version of Painter. And it's becoming more and more obvious that we really need to set up a new workspace rather than trying to import a workspace from a previous version. So that's the other reason I'm doing this the way I've been doing it. All right, so now the next thing we want to do is we're going to start with Series 2. We did Series 1, which was set up. Now Series 2, we're going to start looking at what's new in Painter. And I'm going to take you through how I try to discover Painter. So I'm going to close the welcome window. I'm going to come up to help and I'm going to click on help topics and that will open up Corel Painter help topics. And if you look right here, it says discover and it says what's new in Corel Painter 2023. So if we click on that, that's going to show us what is new in Painter 2023. Now, the first thing it says is we have new fluid paint technology. And it talks about new fluid paint brushes, build and sculpt, paint and blend, and gives some examples. And so basically, what we want to do is just look at what it's saying here and then go explore. All right, so I'm going to minimize this browser and go back to Painter. I'm going to come up to File, New, and I've got set up a 900 by 1000 pixel, 100 pixels per inch. It's just where I like to look. And I've clicked on the fluid brushes that came with us, and I selected this woven group. And we'll stop that. And I'm not going to start painting on a layer. I'm just going to open it up like that. Okay. Now, the first thing I want to do is I would like to see what that paper texture looks like. So while I've got my layer just on the canvas, I'm going to come over here and say show paper texture. There we go. So now we see what it looks like, and that's kind of interesting. We will stay with it, and in the meantime, I want to get rid of that. Okay, so now I know that we're going to be looking at fluid brushes. So I'm going to come over here and find fluid brushes, and if I come look in my Painter 2023 library, I will see two types of fluid brushes, fluid build and sculpt, fluid paint and blend. And at this point, I don't know really what the difference is between them. But we're going to select fluid, build and sculpt, and we'll select the shape builder, which is the first one there. I'm going to hit the reset button to make sure it is at its default setting. And then what I'm going to do is just take a brush and let's see, if I right click this, I can click on the temporal color wheel and pick a color. And I want something kind of olive. That may be a little bit too dark. Come up there. There we go. And then it says brushes. The first thing I do is I hit the canvas. It says brushes that use fluid paint work best on transparent layers. Paint on a new default layer or continue painting on the canvas. And so let's see. Well, let's paint on a new default layer and we'll say OK. That adds a layer, and as you see, it's set at default. But I thought it said they would show best. I don't know why never mind. Let's just keep going and we'll see what happens. All right, so we're on a layer, and I've selected a color, and I just paint. Now, what I'm doing is I'm painting with a light stroke, and then I'm increasing my pressure until I'm really hitting it pretty hard. Then I'm going to let go. And that's what you see. All right, so let's try this again. Light pressure, increase my pressure. So we can get kind of a gradient, although it's going to show some lines. All right, so what's going on here? Let's go up to Advanced Brush Controls, and we'll look first at the General Control Panel. That's where I always go first when I'm looking at new brushes. The first thing to look at is this General Control Panel, and you'll see that this is a captured dab type. Remember, there are all these different dab types that you can have. And this is a captured dab type, which is one of the more popular ones. Once you decide on captured, then you have the option of single, multi-rake, hose, glazing, and single again is the most used. But you can go in there and play with those others just to see what pops up, and we'll do that in a minute. Then the method, we have enhanced cover, legacy cover, and any of these others down here. We're going to stay with this enhanced cover because remember we read something where I think we saw enhanced cover in those help pages. And then the subcategory is soft alpha blend. All right, so let's just light pressure and then increase my pressure until we get dark. All right, now, that soft alpha blend, what if we change that to grainy soft alpha blend? We'll take this off. And as I lightly apply pressure, I want to go a little heavier till I get to the heaviest. And I wonder, I'm thinking I'm not in the right place. So I'm in default modified. Let's go to, oh goodness. We haven't saved any of these. I thought I had. All right, this is important for brushing, and that is to create your own brush tracking, okay? So to do this, we're going to go to brush tracking. We're just going to select the default. That's where we are. And what you want to do over here is draw a brush stroke in the above area building up to maximum pressure and speed. The values are adjusted in response to the brush stroke. All right, so I'm just going to go light and increase my speed and pressure. There we go. All right, so that we could consider is my base. So let's just click on that plus. And we'll add skip base and save. Now, that's going to save it here, and that's what I'm on. But if you'll notice, that and the default is really pretty close. Okay, so I might want to use the default at some point. Now what I want to do is I want a light version. See, if I paint just with light over here, whatever painter picks up, it's going to say, ooh, this guy paints with a very light pressure, so I need to increase the amount of paint with these lighter strokes. So here we're going to go light, faster, and something like that. Looks kind of weird. So light. Nope, too heavy. Light. All right, let's stay with something like that. We'll just see how that works, and we can always delete it. So we're going to go here and call it Skip Slight. I'll show you how this is going to work in a minute. So we save that, and then we're going to do a heavy version where I start heavier and do something like that. Let's do that one again. Start heavier, faster. That looks pretty good. I wanted a deep but natural curve. And so we'll go up here and we'll say skips heavy. and we'll save it. And we'll say, okay, and we're on heavy at the moment. What I'm going to do now is go up to window. I want to close that first. And close that. Go up to window, layout, save layout. And it skips. There was a capital S there. Oops, 2023. Okay. Yes, done. All right, so that's about 10 minutes. That was a little bit different than what I planned. I thought we would get more into painting, but not yet. So I will see you in the next video, which will be video 12. Talk to you then. Bye-bye.